Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Abbas, a full-time orthopedic surgeon and a national level faculty for orthopedics and a part-time YouTuber. In this video, I would like to share my thoughts about the recent results of your grand test conducted by various exams and applications. I'll talk about how that rank and score will affect your preparation towards your final journey to the exam. With this video, I'll try to answer as many questions as possible regarding your concerns and your queries and your apprehensions about your result based on this assessment exam that was conducted by various institutes and app. So without further ado, let's get on with it. Now, recently, many institutes and applications conducted the GRAND test, the computer-based test, the CBTs, the online tests across the country to give you the feeling of the NEET that is coming up just around the corner. And most of you, if not all of you, have appeared for them and you have done well, you have done decently, and some of you have done very good, some of you have done not so good, and some of you have been shocked by the result and you are surprised with the score and the rank that you are getting. And so there are various concerns and queries regarding how accurate they are and what will happen to you, what will be the actual result if you score like this in the exam. So with this video, I'll try to help you come to a conclusion where you stand and what you should be doing based on these scores and ranks. The first thing I want to do is let's evaluate the journey so far. Now, there are a lot of you who have been preparing for a few months. Some of you have been preparing for the last couple of months. Some of you have been preparing for a few weeks. Doesn't matter, but all of you have been preparing towards your final goal, that is your NEET, PG and AIMS. And you've been working very hard. You have been revising. You have been writing notes. You have been attending classes. And you have been taking practice tests, subject-wise tests, grand tests, online tests, MCQs, you've been reviewing, you've been practicing, you have been discussing, you've been soldiering through all these difficult tasks that were put for you to prepare for the entrance exam. And now to assess your preparation, to evaluate where you stand in the whole country, and to assess where you will be if you continue on this path of preparation, you took upon the journey of taking this grand test or the CBT or the online grand test conducted by various institutes and exams. You wrote it, you gave your best shot, and then you got the ranks. You got the ranks and you got the score. A lot of you are disappointed. Some of you are very happy and some of you are indifferent as usual. So that was the journey that you took upon. Now, what I will do is I will try to address what rank you got, and I divide basically this into two categories. So one group or one category of students are this category of students who got exactly what they were expecting based on their preparation. And these are the students who have been working very hard, very smartly, very intelligently. They've been reviewing, revising, practicing, and they've appeared for this CBT or this grand test, and they got a rank which they thought would be somewhere around what they would be getting. So their predictions were almost accurate and they got what they wanted and they deserved. Now, these are the people who are probably not watching my video right now. So these are quite a few, not a lot. So let's not worry about them. So all the best for you guys. You have done very well. I just want to tell you that your preparation is going as planned. Stick to that program and you will definitely get where you want to go. You'll get the seat of your choice. You'll get the institute of your choice. So don't worry about it. Don't dwindle here and there just because your friends are doing this and just because your colleagues are doing that. Stick to your agenda, stick to your program, and you will definitely see yourself reaching there because this exam has proven that to you. Now, the second category of students are the students who couldn't get what they wanted, all right, or they didn't get what they were expecting. Actually, they didn't get what they were expecting. Now, in this strata, again, we have two subtypes. One subtype is the category of students who got really good rank, something that they never imagined they would get. They got beyond their expectations. The other category are the group of students who actually got something very low, something very bad, horrible group is that is what I would like to call them. So these are two groups, a surprised group, a pleasantly surprised group, and the other group is this horribly shocked group. And let's talk about the pleasantly surprised group first. Pleasantly surprised group people, I would want to tell you that this is not a pleasant surprise. You were actually very smart and you are practicing and doing the things that were supposed to be done. It's just that you were probably underconfident and not secure about your planning and strategy. Now, this exam should be an evidence that your plan and strategy is working. So stick to your plan, stick to your strategy, keep on revising and pursue the path that you have already decided to go on, and you will eventually get there. So this is not a pleasant surprise. This is a result of your hard work. So this is a point of fruition of your efforts that you have put in already. So don't be surprised. You were supposed to be there and that is why you're there. The second subtype are the category of people who are horribly shocked. by their rank and score. Now, this video is primarily for them because these are the people who are filling my inbox with questions. Sir, what will happen? Mera kya hoga? Marks nahi aaye, rank nahi laga. Now, to this horribly shocked group of people, I would first like to say is relax. Dheeraj rakho, thande ho jao. Pehle baith jao, pani pilo. Don't worry. There is nothing to be afraid of. There is nothing to be worried just based on one rank and one score. Theek hai na? To aaram se pehle baith jao aur meri baat suno. I'll talk to you. I'll tell you what is the problem here and we'll solve this together so that you get what you want. Okay. First thing I would want to tell you is that any exam that is conducted in our country, whether it's conducted by an institute, conducted by an app, no exam can be an accurate replica of the final exam. This is what I want to tell you. Every exam that you're writing for the final exam preparation, you should consider that exam as an exam that will replicate your exam almost 60 to 70%. Matlab, if you prepare a question paper that is even the most perfect question paper that would try to replicate the final exam, the chances of it being accurate representation of your final exam are around 60 to 70%. No paper can replicate an exam 100%. And if they are doing it, they are probably cheating. So don't worry about it. Every exam, there is a margin of 30 to 40% of error. So to feel confident, we'll bank on the fact that that 30 to 40% of error is the error that we are working with here. So don't worry, take it with a pinch of salt. Your score and your rank, add some masala to it and that is what you will get in the final exam. Now, some people add positive masala, some people add negative masala. For now, just hold on, don't add anything. Let me finish what I have to tell you. Listen to me very carefully and once the video is over, write down in the comments and tell me what you feel. So the horribly shocked group of people are probably the 90% of people watching this video. I want you to understand this one very important thing. The grand test or the app test that you have written right now, I want you to imagine that test as an assessment tool, as a tool. For example, if you want to take a photograph, what tool do you use? You'd use a camera. If you want to communicate with someone, what tool do you use? You use a phone. Now, similarly, this grand test or the CBT test was a tool for your assessment. Because when you start preparing and when you're preparing for a final exam that is eventually going to come a few months later, you constantly need to check yourself whether you're on the right path or not. This is very important because sometimes what happens is in our journey of preparation, we lose track, we lose focus, and then we take a detour and this detour may make us lost. So these exams, these grand tests are there to help you assess or evaluate your progress. Nothing more, nothing less. They are just tools to assess your progress. And I want you to use these tools properly for your best results. Don't take anything from it other than that they are a tool. They are just an instrument for your success. The rank, the score does not matter. What matters is what I will tell you now. I want you to use this examination, this assessment exam, to assess your weak points. Now, if you got a score which was less, I want you to assess it. Why? Why did you get this less score? You've prepared very hard. You have revised multiple times. You have written multiple MCQ exams. Why on earth did you get such a low score? Now, I want you to evaluate your problem in two headings. One is your general or environmental factors. The other is your subject or academic factors. I want you to assess based on these two factors. Now, the general factors or the environmental factors, I want you to understand what could have been the problem that made you get a low score. Was it a problem of time management? Were you tired or sleepy during the exam? Were you hungry? Were you thirsty during the exam? Did you have difficulty adapting to the environment? Was it too hot in the exam hall? Was it too cold in the exam hall? Or was it a computer problem, a keyboard problem, a mouse problem? Was it an electricity problem? Or were you too tensed or stressed to answer those MCQs? Now, these are your general or environmental problems that I want you to evaluate very carefully, very critically. What could have gone wrong that made you get such a low score? So use these headings and these pointers to evaluate yourself, to assess where it went wrong. Now, coming to the subject or academic problems, what could have been these subject or academic problems? Did you often make silly mistakes? Were you unable to recall the facts in the exam? Were you confused about a certain concept or did you learn that concept wrong? Did you write that fact in your notes wrong? Or did you hear the teacher wrong? Or did you totally leave out that topic or subject? Were you unable to recall what you read for that exam? Were you unable to identify the image? Was the image new to you? Absolutely something you have never seen previously? Did you remember it wrong? You probably misplaced the position of the table in your memory.
So I want you to step by step evaluate all these problems and very critically look at where you made the mistake. Now, once you start evaluating yourself, you will realize automatically that this could have been the flaw, this could have been the flaw, my concept was probably wrong, I did not revise this table, I have written this table wrong, I have heard this teacher wrong. So you start correcting them one by one. Now, once you have evaluated all these problems I told you, you have to step by step try to seek if you can fix them. Is it fixable or not? Is environment fixable? Is your general problem fixable? Is time management a problem? If time management is your problem, you need to work on your time management. Read the questions quickly. If there are long questions, mark them and come back to it later. If there are questions that are being asked from the topics or subjects which you are generally weak in, not strong in, you mark them, move ahead and do the topics which you're comfortable with and then come back. So utilize techniques to manage your time properly. Are you tired or sleepy in the exam? If you are, please watch my previous video where I told you to fix your sleep cycle. This is very important because what happens is we tend to read throughout the night and in the day we are drowsy and sleepy. And if we are drowsy and sleepy in the day, during the exam time, we'll not be able to utilize the brain power to reproduce the facts for the exam. So try to keep your mind fresh. The maximum amount of freshness of your mind should be during the exam time. So fix your sleep cycle. That is very important. Were you hungry or thirsty in the exam? If you were hungry or thirsty in the exam, make sure that you have a good meal or a proper meal before you go for the exam and you carry water with you. If they are not allowing water with you, you see that you're well hydrated. Make sure that these problems are not reproduced in the final exam. Was there a computer, mouse or a keyboard problem? If there was a computer, mouse or a keyboard problem, I suggest you just take a break, stand up and ask the examiner to come and fix it as soon as possible. If you stand up and if you're loud enough, they will definitely hear, they'll come and fix it. You cannot write the exam with a damaged mouse or keyboard. So address these problems. Were these the cause of your low score? Were you stressed? Were you tensed? Because if you were stressed and tensed, I will teach you how to focus in the exam in my next video and how to circumvent the stress factors and factors that will make you tense in the exam. So we'll address them in the next video. Now, these are the environmental or general factors that probably would have led you to get a lower score. What about the subject or academic factors? The silly mistakes. Why did you make those silly mistakes? Did you not revise them properly? I mean, you have to make a list of things that you need to revise before the exam. If you keep on revising, you will not make those silly mistakes again and again. Did you leave out a subject? If you have left out a subject, please do not leave out a subject. I have constantly told you on my channel that you should not leave out any subject. And even if you do, if you watch my previous videos, you will see that I have told you that you should at least do the last 3 or 4 years of MCQ topics. And if you have difficulty or if you are afraid of certain subjects, there is a video that I have prepared of 4 important tips or 4 super tips that will help you read those difficult subjects. Watch that. It will help you. I'll put it up over here for you to access it. Were you unable to identify the images? If you were unable to identify the images, you have to browse through the standard textbooks. Whenever you read a topic, browse through the standard textbook, look at the images, just browse through them. Those images will be recalled in your exam. These are the images that will come in your exam, nothing out of these books. Did you remember something wrong? This again goes back to your revision. If you revise, you will not remember things wrong. If you remember, I told you, make a list of the topics that you need to revise for the exam, because these are very volatile topics. So you have to make a list of these topics that you're constantly forgetting. And these exams will help you know what are the topics that you're forgetting. So address these problems if you can. So basically, this exam will help you comb out your problems and weaknesses and identify them and let you work on them to improve them so that they are not reproduced when it really matters. This exam does not matter. Your final exam matters. And this exam is just a simulation of the final exam to help you understand where you're weak, what mistakes you're making so that you do not repeat these mistakes in the final exam and you have a better chance of getting a better score. So essentially, more the exams you write, the better you will identify your problems and better you will fix them. So what am I trying to tell you over here? I'm saying that more exams you write, the better you will get at it. So this is very important for students who hesitate writing grand test, who hesitate from appearing for exams just because they feel I've not prepared. You will never know if you're prepared or not if you don't write these exams. These exams will tell you whether you're prepared or not. So write as many exams as you possibly can. Learn from your mistakes, identify your weak problem subjects, work on them, improve them, do not repeat these mistakes in the final exam. That's the whole idea of writing these tests. That's it, nothing more, nothing less. So this exam, this score, this mark represents nothing more than just a tool to help you improve for the final exam. So if you've gotten a low score, there is no need to feel bad about it. It has just helped you identify your weaknesses. Identify them, fix them, move on. That's it. Write the next test. So sir, you're saying the rank does not matter, the score does not matter. So what matters? Excellent question. So what matters is the fact that you keep on progressing, you keep on increasing your score, and you keep on getting better ranks as you keep on writing the exam. The whole idea is that your next test, the score of your next test should be better than this test. That's it. It doesn't matter by how much. Even if you score one mark better than your previous score, what does it say? It says that you're improving. That is the idea. You have good time. You have some 7 or 8 weeks left. You can write those 7 or 8 grand tests and you can assess yourself. The idea is to keep on increasing one mark or one test at a time. Don't let one test decide your future. If you keep on slowly, marginally improving every 1 week, by the end of the preparation, you will realize the compound effect of those weeks and you will realize that you have come so far away. If you are a person who were able to only do 100 or 120 correct out of 300 questions, you will realize by the end of your preparation, by keep on doing those exams, you are able to do 180, 200, 210. So this is slow and slow marginal improvement that will compound and give you the result that you want. So that is basically what I wanted to address in this video. So there is nothing to feel bad about your score, your rank. You know, it is easy to fall into the negativity trap. Ye kyun hua, mere saath kyun hua? That examination is a fraud exam. They have kept the MCQs from their classes, from their notes. It doesn't matter. Let them screw you. Let the apps screw you. Let the institute screw you. Doesn't matter. What matters is your final exam. These institutes and apps, they cannot make your final exam. Final exam is going to be made by the board, and they are going to make whatever they want, and you are trying to target that exam. So don't fall into the trap of negativity. Take your score, take your rank, understand your problems, and then move forward. It is very easy to fall into the negativity trap. Don't fall. Don't pity yourself if you've gotten a bad score. Thank yourself that you have identified it right now and not in the exam, and work hard for it. If you've sat through the whole video, thank you for watching my video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have not already subscribed, please consider subscribing. Have a great day. I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.